So we're here in the city centre of Hull, upgrading the Mytongate roundabout. This will be up through here, the westbound offslip. So this is an existing burial ground called the Trinity Burial Ground. This was in use from the late 18th century through to the late 19th century. To create the space for that slip road, we have to exhume a number of burials here. They will get reburied within the boundaries of the burial ground. The first activity here was to strip the topsoil. We had to screen all of the topsoil in case of any bones or findings. We have our Balfour Beatty resources in here providing the machinery to do some bulk excavation. We're working closely with Oxford Archaeology, who are providing the archaeologists here and the field team. We'll also be undertaking some detailed analysis on 1,500 of these skeletons.
So we're in the osteology laboratory. This is where we analyse the skeletons. We're analysing a sample of 1,500 skeletons from amongst those that we excavate. The excavation is largely undertaken by hand, using a range of hand tools. We then carry out quite a detailed record of the position of the bones, the position of the burial, are all recorded digitally into an online database using tablets. We carefully lift the bones and put them in bags. They're excavated as carefully as we can, and all of the finds and items associated with the burials are returned to them before they are reburied back on site with them part of the site that's not going to fall within the scheme. This is the largest excavation of a 18th to 19th century burial ground in the north of England. The site gives us an unprecedented insight into the lives of the population of a significant industrialising port city at that time.
So as well as the benefits for the road users and the pedestrians, this particular bit of work in Trinity Burial Ground gives us a real opportunity to leave a legacy for Hull and a greater understanding of their history.